Hi everyone, welcome to Power Semiconductor Drive lecture series. In the previous lecture, we studied about the synchronous motor fed by cycloconverter and the closed loop operation of synchronous motor. Now we'll study the numerical problems based on the synchronous motor control schemes. This is the first problem. A 5 megawatt 3 phase 11 kV 50 head TPF 6 pole star connected synchronous motor has the following parameters. Xs is equal to 10 ohms, rated field current is 60, assume the armature resistance is negligible. The machine is controlled by a variable frequency at constant V by F ratio up to the base speed and at constant V above the base speed. Torque for rated armature current 750 rpm and 0.8 power factor leading. Also draw the motor characteristics and waveforms under the above mentioned control scheme. So this is the actual question. Here in the question they mentioned there is no armature resistance. That means you can consider there is no losses in the machine. That means the input power is equal to the mechanical power or developed power in the system. That is the first point you should remember there. And next one is, here they asked to find out field current and torque at 750 rpm with rated armature current and 0.8 power factor leading. So that means the actual question is on UPF. Machine is works on UPF and the speed, actual speed we have to find out. That is, actual speed is based on the synchronous machine, that is synchronous machine formula. NS is equal to synchronous speed, NS is equal to 120 F by P. If you calculate the speed will be 1000 rpm, the actual speed of the machine. What they are asking about at 750 rpm we have to find out, and also the power factor is 0.8. So at 0.8 and 750 rpm with rated armature current we have to find out field current and torque. This is the actual question they asked. Okay, so let's move on to the solution now. Given in the given data we have only that is the mechanical power, that is 5 megawatt is nothing but a mechanical power, and next one is the line voltage is 11 kV and frequency is 50 hertz. So here they given a star connection. So line voltage 11 kV, then we can find out V phase, that is phase voltage is line voltage by root 3. So we will get 6350.85, that is the phase voltage. In star connection, line and phase currents, whereas in phase voltage is equal to VL by root 3. Okay, next one is power factor. In the given question, the given power factor is 1, that is UPF, and next one is number of poles is 6, and RS is equal to 0 ohm, XS is 10 ohms actually they given, but here they printed as 9 ohms, that's why I made a correction here, that is 10 ohms from the given question, and IF is rated field current is 60 amps. Machine is actually running with 60 amps field current, but we have to find out at 750 rpm and also 0.8 power factor, we have to calculate torque and speed. The given question they mentioned that RS is equal to 0 degrees, 0 ohms, sorry. 0 ohms is nothing but there is no losses. That means we can consider the mechanical power is equal to input power. Mechanical power is equal to input power is root 3 VL IL cos phi. Here all are line parameters. That's why you mentioned root 3. If you consider the phase value, do V phase I phase cos 3 into V phase I phase cos. But here they taken only line value. That's why root 3 into VL IL cos phi. All the line values. Okay, so power is nothing but the mechanical power they mentioned as 5 megawatts. Just directly you can substitute 5 into 10 to the power of 6 into root 3 into VL value, line value. Just directly you can consider line value 11 kV, that is 11 into 10 to the power of 3. And IS is nothing but the supply current or source current, or we can consider it as an armature current also, into cos phi, that is a given actual given machine running at UPF. That's why cos phi is 1. So with that we can calculate IS is equal to 262.43 at an angle of 0 degrees. This is the armature current at rated current of the machine, which the machine is actually running with the rated supply. IS is equal to 262.43 at an angle of 0 degree. Now next one is, this is the equivalent circuit to the synchronous machine, phase equivalent. All the parameters are phase parameters only. That's why they mentioned here in the next step they mentioned E phase is equal to V phase minus IS into JXS. This is the equation which is derived from the equivalent circuit of the synchronous machine. So E is nothing but the induced EMF. So we can calculate V phase. E phase is nothing but V phase minus IS into JXS. So V phase is 350.853 minus IS value, just now we calculated 262.43 at an angle of 0, plus J into 10, XS is 10. So J plus J is nothing but angle 90 degrees. So if you multiply the magnitude 262.43 into 10, 262.43 is 2624.3 at an angle of 90 degrees, or J can be replaced with 90 degrees here. the real part is 63. Then we can convert this rectangular form into a polar form, we will get 6871.69 at an angle of minus 22.45 degrees. This is nothing but the induced EMF at rated synchronous speed, or you can say at 1000 RPM, because NS is equal to 120 F by P. This is the rated speed, actual speed of the mission, 1000 RPM. At 1000 RPM, this is the induced EMF 6871.69. And E at an angle of delta. Delta is nothing but the load angle. That is, the load angle is minus 22.45 degrees at 1000 RPM. But the question they asked about torque and field currents at 750 RPM. That means we have to convert this induced EMF to 750 RPM. We already know there is an OCC characteristics. For simple understanding, I am considering this one as OCC characteristics. This is the OCC characteristics drawn with IF versus. For simple understanding, I am considering this one, voltage and current, and then we can consider these. For example, if you consider this is the OCC characteristics. So for the same field current, we are getting the voltage, that is induced EMF here. This is the actual induced EMF. This is the OCC curve drawn at 1000 RPM. Actually, I doesn't have any writing pad, that's why I'm trying to write with the mouse only. Just excuse us and understand what I am saying, because I doesn't have writing pad to clearly note this one. Just I am using the mouse to represent the diagram. That's why the diagram will be like this. Okay. So this is the field current. For the rated field current. For the rated field current, this is the induced EMF. For example, this is E1. Okay, and this is OCC curve is drawn at 1000 RPM. But in the question, they mentioned for 750 RPM, we need to consider the rated current. 750 RPM, we have to calculate IF and also torque. For 750 RPM, this is the OCC curve. 750 RPM. For 750 RPM, this is the OCC curve. For the same rated field, the induced EMF will be changed here. This is the induced EMF. Here the point will be E2. If we consider this one is E2. Okay. Is E2. So for the same IF, they mentioned in the question itself, for 60 amp field current, E1 is just now we calculated 687.69. But we need to find out at 750 RPM the remaining parameter. That's why we need to convert this induced EMF for 750 RPM. So for 750 RPM, what is the value of E2? We have to find out. So this is the next step we need to find out. For 750 RPM and the same rated field current, what is the value of E2? This is the first step we need to find out. For this, we can look at here. This is highlighted for. At rated field current and 750 RPM, E is nothing but 6871.69 into 750 by 1000. What is this 750? 750 is actual, we need to find out the speed at which the IF and torque are calculated. That is 750 RPM is the mentioned speed. We need to find out the remaining parameter. 1000 is nothing but the actual speed of the mission, and 6871.69 is nothing but the induced EMF at 1000 RPM. That means here we are considering that directly the relation is E is proportional to speed. Induced EMF is proportional to the speed. This is the case they considered. Okay. So with this we can calculate E2 by E1 is nothing but N2 by N1. Simply we can identify E2 value is 5153.76. 5153.76. You can cross check that one also. The value is 5153.76. Okay. This is the induced EMF at 750 RPM at the rated field current. Okay. So, okay. Next, move on to the next step, the problem. Okay. At 750 RPM and 0.8 power factor leading, frequency, that means the frequency also changes because the speed also changes. So, speed is changing means the frequency also changes. N is directly proportional to frequency. With that relation, we can calculate the frequency at 750 RPM, that is 37.5 Hz. For this frequency, we have to calculate induced EMF. What is the for this frequency? That is a 37.5 hertz. We need to first calculate induced EMF. What amount of induced EMF is get at 750 RPM and also at frequency 37.5 hertz? Because the frequency is also changed and the power factor is also changed, 0.8. That's why we need to calculate at this frequency. First we need to calculate the transfer. So we calculate one by one. First we need to find out the phase value. This phase value is nothing but previously the given data VL by root 3 we calculated. VL by root 3 is the actual given question data at 50 hertz frequency. Now we are trying to calculate the voltage at 37.5 hertz frequency. Here also the voltage and frequency are directly proportional. That's why they are calculated into 37.5 by 50. With that formula we can calculate 4763.14. This is the voltage, phase voltage at 37.5 hertz frequency. Similarly we can calculate the synchronous reactance, because it is also depends upon the frequency parameter only. We know clearly excess is also depends upon the frequency, directly proportional to frequency only. That's why they calculated and 7.5 ohms. These are 7.5 ohms reactance value. Next we will move on to the E phase. So with these parameters we can calculate the E phase value, that is E dash E complement we can calculate complement minus IS into J excess complement. So this is the formula. And if you substitute this one, you will get the polar form. This is the polar form. Polar form is 6148.881 at an angle of minus 14.84 degree. This is the phase value. So we are getting the magnitude here 6148.88 at the given power factor and 750 RPM and also the frequency, calculated frequency based on the 750 RPM, 37.5 hertz. So this is the actual induced EMF at the given conditions, what we need to calculate based on the speed and power factor and also the frequency. Based on these three parameters, the actual induced EMF in the machine will be 6148.88. Okay. So if you want to in voltage, then what is the field current we need? What is the field current we need? That is the first step we need to calculate. The question itself, first problem is field current we need to calculate. So to get this much of induced EMF, that is 6148.88 volts, how much amount of field current we require? That's the first step we need to find out. So see here, the first one, field current is directly proportional to the voltage only. That's why the calculation will goes on like this. Here the E dash by E into IF1, E dash by E into IF1. IF1 is the given rated field current, that is 60 amps. E dash is nothing but the frequency. The given condition, the induced EMF E dash is 6148.88. And E is nothing but the, at 750 RPM we calculated 53.70. This induced EMF we should consider. Don't consider the 1000 RPM induced EMF, because we need to calculate at 750 RPM. The OCC curve is shifted now. Previously it is 1000 RPM, now it is 750 RPM. So at 750 RPM, all the parameters we need to find. Okay. So previously we calculated this one, 5153.76 is nothing but the induced EMF at 750 R rated field current. But we need, now the field current is changed and the induced EMF is also changed. That's why we are using this induced EMF. Clearly you can cross check this one. Field current is nothing but E dash by E into IF1. E dash is nothing but 6148.88 by E is nothing but 5153.76. This is also all the parameters at 750 RPM only. All the parameters are at 750 RPM only with field current, that is 71.58 amperes. This is the 71.58 amperes. This much of field current is required to generate 6148.88 volts of induced EMF at the given RPM and decay. So next one is output power, because next parameter we need to find out is torque. So for the torque calculation, we need a mechanical power and also the speed, angular speed we need. That's why first we need to find out output power. Output power is nothing but 3 V phase. All the phase parameters here they consider. That's why the power will be 3 times of VI cos phi. If we consider line values, the root 3 times of VLIL cos phi will be occur. Okay. So that is the one you should consider. So power is nothing but the 3 into V phase I phase cos phi. V phase I phase cos phi. For changed conditions, we should consider the V phase value. Previously we calculated the V phase value is 4763. Change conditions means for 750 rpm and the frequency is 37.5 hertz, and also power factor is 0.8 power factor. For that conditions, the V phase value is 4763. These are the changed conditions parameters. And I phase is 263.43, because in the question they mentioned at rated armature current only we need to find out all the unknown parameters. That's why the IS value will not change from the actual condition. This 263.43 into cos phi is 0.8, and the value will around 3000. We are getting 3000 kilowatt. We are getting the output power for the given condition. And next, in radians per second, we need to consider the actual speed is given is 750 rpm. That is, we need to calculate at 750 rpm. But we need to in angular, in terms of angular speed. That's why 2 pi into omega is nothing but 2 pi n by 60. 2 pi n is nothing but 750 rpm by 60. With that formula, we can calculate 78.54 radians per second. So this is the act, this is the speed we considered. This is the speed, and this one is power. Then we can easily calculate the torque also. Torque is nothing but the power by speed, radians per second, angular speed. So around 3000 by 78.54, we get the torque value 38195.69 newton meters. So this is the actual torque at the given conditions. At the given condition means, always I am remembering you, they told that we need to find out field current and torque at 750 rpm, and also the power factor is 0.8 power factor with rated armature current. That is the actual condition they given. That's why we calculated the field current 71.58, and also the power value is, torque is also 38195.69 newton meter. This is the values of the given problem. And one more thing here, they asked about basic characteristics. You can clearly identify the theory class we studied this one character. Below base speed, this is the reference point. Below base speed, this is the